Off the coast of Brazil, a team of treasure hunters is sailing to one of the most dangerous places in the world, Snake Island.
I think we're gonna be going basically where nobody's gone before. Somebody actually made a list of the 10 worst places to visit in the world.
And this is it?
This is number one.
Nobody has ever landed and searched for the treasure on this island.
So, like, why don't you give us an idea of what we're really gonna be dealing with when we get on that island?
Snake Island has the highest density of venomous snakes anywhere in the world.
If you average the population over the entire island, you'd end up with one snake per square meter. But of course, there may be areas that we encounter where there may be 20, 30 snakes in a very small vicinity. We want to behave in a non-threatening way. Slow, smooth motion.
What do we do if we do get bit? What's the process?
Number one thing is keep the person calm and keep them immobile. If you get bit, you could very realistically end up losing a hand or an entire arm, but death will be from bleeding issues. I've had bites like this, and I started bleeding out of my nose first, and then I started bleeding out of my eyes. It was like stigmata. It was the coolest thing ever.
Yeah. You and I definitely have a different version of what cool is.
Yeah, not cool.
We hope this treasure is worth risking our lives for.
In 1524, Portuguese conquistador Alexo Garcia led an expedition through the uncharted jungles of Brazil, hunting for Incan gold. Garcia formed an alliance with the native Guarani warriors. Together, they attacked and pillaged Incan settlements as they marched inland. It's said Garcia amassed a vast fortune before he was driven back by the great Incan king, Huaynacapac. But then Garcia's allies, the Guarani warriors, became greedy. They killed Garcia and his men and claimed the treasure for themselves. The Incan gold reportedly made its way to the coast. Legend has it that the Guarani feared reprisals, so they hid the fortune in the most daunting and secure place they knew, Snake Island.
There she is. Snake Island is isolated, it's covered in deadly snakes. I mean, what better place to hide treasure?
We're good. We are good here.
Let me pull it up to the side, Jeremy.
That'll work.
Throw me the black line.
Before the team risks their lives on this snake-infested island, they want to find evidence that the legend might be true. The only way the treasure could have been transported to the island is by ship, so the team will search for signs of nautical activity from the late 1500s, the time when the treasure disappeared.
Grab the transducer.
Got it.
Radio?
Got it.
Snake Island is so dangerous, it'd be totally irresponsible to launch a major expedition after treasure on that island just based on theory alone.
We're just doing a dry run.
Go ahead.
We need solid evidence of something man-made along the ocean floor. That could be debris from a ship from that time period, or it could actually be the full shipwreck itself.
Snake Island is remote and just 1 square kilometer in size. Its huge snake population has made it completely uninhabitable. If Cork's team finds remnants of a vessel from the late 1500s on its shoreline, it could indicate that people were on the island over 400 years ago. Perhaps they were here to hide something of considerable value.
What we're looking for right now is a footprint of the treasure, not the treasure itself. We could find just artifacts, we could find parts of ships. We could even find a ship with its full cargo in there of amazing value. You just never know.
Cork's assembled a team of professionals to take on this dangerous hunt. Venomous snake expert Brian Fry.
Here, I'm gonna slow myself down to you.
Anthropologist and dive expert Megan Heaney-Greer.
a little more weight for my weight belt, and I'm gonna get my gear set up.
Ship's engineer Jeremy Whalen is skilled in the use of sonar technology.
You guys seen anything?
With a side scan sonar? I mean, it looks down to 1,000 feet below us. And not only does it give an image of the bottom, it's also GPS marked, so we know exactly where it's at.
Just taking a minute to set up.
And Captain Keith Plaskett, an experienced adventurer.
We can see rocks, and you can see the ripples from the sand.
The problem is, every day that we are looking for evidence is costing me money, because I've got my own money in here. Plus, we've only got a 2-month window to execute this operation and find that treasure. After that, the weather will change, storms will come in, and they'll prevent us from doing any type of landing whatsoever on Snake Island.
We're in a remote, inhospitable area, but, you know, for me, this is as close to a religious experience as I'm ever gonna come. This is my Mecca. Yeah. This is why I'm here. This is my golden treasure.
Let me know if you see anything. I'll be taking a nap back here.
This sonar search is painstaking, really grinds on my patience, but we have to do it. I mean, there's no way we're getting on that damn island without some evidence of 16th century shipping activity in these waters.
Seeing anything?
This looks like school of fish on this side.
We've been searching for a couple days.
We haven't found anything yet, but this is a very difficult test. I mean, it's as hard as trying to find a needle in a thorny, ocean-sized haystack.
Modern-day treasure hunting isn't what you'd imagine it to be. It's a cutthroat business. It's not shoveling dirt, digging holes. It's the art of gathering intel, gathering information. And the ones who win are the ones who get the best information.
Local intelligence has led Cork to these specific waters. A meeting with a fisherman helped him identify a potential shipwreck site just off Snake Island.
I'm hoping that local bit of recon is going to pay off, because I'm banking on the idea that it'll cut down on our search time.
But today's technology, you save so much time, because the old archaic ways of doing things is taking two boats and running a long chain between the two boats and dragging it on the bottom until it hooks something. That's time we don't have. We like this because it's low profile. It's like we're just cruising around out here with a little dinghy behind the boat.
Attracting attention could be fatal. Modern day pirates often terrorize ships passing through this region.
I've encountered a lot of pirates out there. If they think there's any kind of chance that you have anything on board like treasure, they won't hesitate to come on board and kill you. These waters are not safe at all.
I'm readjusting the side scan a little bit. We're back in business.
I think I'll check if we can turn.
Yep.
What's up, Cap?
There's something coming up. Look at that. Go tell him.
What does it look like?
It's got structure to it.
What are you guys saying?
Maybe it's a pile of bricks. I don't know. Looks like a long pipe or something. Oh, yeah, look at that.
Oh, man.
Look at that.
Oh, my God.
That's man-made.
If I can zoom in on it.
How big is that, you think?
Looks to be around 10 feet or so. This is huge. Yeah, I think we got something here, man.
After a painstaking search, the crew of the Alpha Crucis may have what they're looking for.
Who knows what it could be? It could be a ballast pile. It could be any type of formation that's not normal to that area.
We don't know until we go down and check it out.
Totally blown away right now.
We got a good image on there. Good days with the side scan sonar, let me tell you.
If we have found a man-made object in these waters in the time period that we're looking for of late 1500s, early 1600s, that means we'll be able to take the next step, which is to land on Snake Island.